off the mark immediately is Annika Bosch. Joins Lara Goddard at the top of the order. Edge, I thought. Yes, I thought, and it has been given. Sarah Bartlett, on debut as well, gives the decision. There wasn't a huge appeal. I thought there was a nick. They've reviewed it. Lara Goodall.
Okay, ball is passing close to the bat. I'd like to check with Ulcha Edge, please. Thank you. All the way through, please. Gap between bat and ball. All the way through, please. Okay, the ball is past the bat. I'm satisfied there is no bat involved.
Yeah! Doesn't matter anyway now. The grin tells it all. And there's nothing more conclusive than that.
But if there's one thing I know about Katherine Brunt, that she loves bowling at left-handers, gets the ball to shape nicely in. Goodall looking to go down the ground. A successful review, this time a seam-up. Traditional delivery from Katherine Brunt. A bit of nip as well off the seam. That's an outstanding delivery from the senior pro.
Sune Lys, South African captain.
Wait on.
In to replace Lara Goodall. And unfortunately, Lydia, Goodall's poor summer continues. Successful over for England and for Katherine Brunt, one for one. That's flicked away very nicely indeed. The first boundary for South Africa comes by the way of a wristy flick from Annika Bosch. Inside edge, playing on, and it's the 100th T20 international wicket for Katherine Brunt. And well might she celebrate. This decorated cricketer has added another milestone onto her tally, and in so doing has reduced South Africa with the captain gone. Almost squeezing through again. Tentative start from Wolf Hart, but she gets off the mark. Struck pretty well, just past the flailing right hand of Katherine Brunt and the despairing dive of Sophie Eccleston.
That will be Laura Woolbart's fourth international T20 50, very much anchored the innings for South Africa. Should be out, and it is simple catch for Sophia Dunkley. Tucker trying to go up and over the infield. Katherine Brunt, she is in the wickets, the third one of the evening for her.
So she'll stay leg side and just doesn't get enough of it, just slices it. And a simple catch for Sophia Dunkley.
That's going down. They push hard for two, but they don't. That means that Jafta stays on strike. That's the end of the 18th over, 97 for six. Well, shouts of catch, it is a chance, and it's an excellent catch from that sieve up, patrolling the deep mid-wicket boundary, having to dive forward, always tough chances, and she takes it, and that's Katherine Brunt's 102nd wicket. She now joins Anya Shrubsole on that number, leading T20 wicket taker for England.
And this is made to look quite a simple catch, and I can assure you now this isn't. to get in position, to dive forward, to make it look so easy. That is Nat Siver. That's not an easy catch. It's a superb catch. And Katherine Brunt, yes.
Oh, yes, Catho. Good, Brunty. Oh, yes, Catho.
Oh, she does. She looks to have a swipe, can't get the contact that she wants. Where's the slower ball? Back of the hand, slower ball.
There's the slower ball. What's coming next, Yorker?
Oh. Yes, Nat!
They are going to try and come back for two. This will be a run-out opportunity. Yeah. It should be simple, and it is. Amy Jones taking the ball cleanly from the Nat Siver throw. And Mazabata Class is going to fall well short. Last delivery for Katherine Brunt. No, it isn't. One more.
Teasing her, she wants five.
Oh, finishes with a dot ball. South Africa end their innings, 111 for nine. And Katherine Brunt finishes with career best figures, 4 for 15. She's been outstanding today, picking up wickets in the power play, also in the back end of the innings for England.